Hi everyone, this is a finish off a few bits and pieces that have been sitting in my pile and stash for quite a while. Now, a year ago I did a little class which had, I think it was possibly with Willa Wanders, a whole heap of little classes with different people. No, I could be wrong, but anyway, it was one of those join this and you'll get a class by these many people as testers for their bigger classes. And this was one of the little assignments, and it's a little folded, basically a little book to put things in. So I finished the book, but then I realized, well, I should make some little tags to go in. So I found this is a notepad I've had for ages, which was designed by my brother and his wife a long time ago, and it related to a whole heap of kids books that they were making at the time. They've moved on to adult books. Maybe I'll see if I can find a link below for them. So I've cut a couple of the pages out and I've got these, and I'm thinking I'll reserve them for another time. So I did a template to double check. So I've got one of these tag cutters, which has got three different sizes. And I just did a template and to work out the size. And then I have measured these little bits of paper and cut them so that they're the right size. So now I'm just stamping them in my little stampy-doo thing. And they just do a beautiful top. So I thought I would make a few of these and do some collaging. Let's see, if they're thin enough, I might just try and do a bulk cut. Easy. Right. Leaves it all behind under there. These are really quite, this is Creative Memories. It's really, I love it. It's quite a good one. You can lock it shut and so it stores away a little bit better. Alright, so I have now got one for every pocket. If I can find the actual class that was with. I've made sure they're thin because I'm going to collage on them, so it'll be thicker. So this would be the middle because it opens that way, and I've glued them together so as it just stays in its book form. So I've used two types of scrapbooking papers, one for the inside, one for the outside, and then another one for the cover, which is just folded over a bit of cardboard, and then the back and the front are stuck down. So this is how my little book will be with a whole heap of collages. So start with number one. I think I'll maybe get something to lean on. I think I might like to use my Stabilo Woodies. Sorry about the noise. And where did my little coloured things go? So following on from my, I was making buttons, my friend's scrapbook. So this will be in the Rick Rack Club. My friend's scrapbook, she was brushing off her paintbrush and she just used this old cheap thing. And so I actually was using my cutter and cutting out a whole heap of those, and then making a whole heap of buttons. Anyway, that's in the Rick Rack Club. Got a learning how to balance these two now. So, think about I'll use a glue stick. Just thinking what colour scheme I might like. This is nice thin paper too. Might use a little bit of that. Stick those down. Actually, I think I'll keep this book with its fine paper for a bit of collaging and use this. This is very, you know, it's quite thick paper. Oh, look at that. Oh, I might keep that for something else. Oh, that's exciting. Maybe I'll keep the end for something too. All right. Actually, I think I'll put this underneath. Yeah, here's a little bit of purple. And I have a jar of water now, since I cleaned up my bench. No one knows that because that was in the Rick Rack Club while I was talking about it. However, the Rick Rack Club is just the once a month you can join it, and the button is on the front page of my YouTube. It just says join. Coffee a month, not much. There's tutorials coming up in there, and there'll be freebies and all kinds of stuff. Not free, obviously, if you're paying for the club, but there you go, there will be things, all the things. Okay, so this could be just as it is, nice and simple. I've got to wait for that to dry a bit. I think I'd like to use, just trying to see, I took all my, I've taken all my pens and things out to, let's get this scrap one. I'm just going to see how that goes over that. There's a little bit of experimentation going on here. Nice, this colour. Oh yes, it'll work once it's dry. Not seeing it very much, really. Probably needs a different colour. Yes, anyway, so I have cleaned up my entire space. I have sorted everything out, packed more things away, and cleared my desk. So I actually now have a little pile to my right of the little bits and pieces like this that I have left sitting for ages and not done anything with. So this could be my first little card. I don't think it needs a lot more than that. And it will just slide in there. I think, I might like something bright that goes over here. And as I said, I already said, probably it's at Wood End. So I've just come in with an overdub here and sped up this tag. I just wanted to test out how the sound is with my new iPad and how it all works, because the formats are slightly different, so I'm still on a learning curve. So I've decided to have a bit of a play with a different colour, bringing in a green, testing out, playing, just having fun, put some music on in the background, thus the overdub, and just seeing what works. There doesn't have to be any real golden rule about it. It's all about having fun and doing what's working for you. So I'm playing here with a bit of a permanent markers or Sharpies, got paint pens, and mark making. So you can see I've just done the first two now, and I'm going to work my way through the book with the same couple of principles. So I've got my little bit of type, I've got a little bit of the wipe off paintbrush book from my friend that she gave me. There's just little scraps after making the buttons, and some mark making with the Stabilo Woodies, Posca pens or paint pens, and the permanent markers or Sharpies. And I'm just playing, basically. So I might put a little bit of music on and get to the end of my fast forwards. So here's the part where I started to expand, which is what is really great about doing lots of these projects. Doing a few in a row means that you, sooner or later, you get bored with what you've set yourself, the task, and then you can bring back in some ideas. So here I've just decided that I've got these beautiful bits of paper which have been hand-painted, or, well, they're brush marks by my friend, but still hand-painted. And I just decided to cut up little bits and add them as part of the collage. I'm getting working my way through the book, and what I'm going to do now is come back and show you all of the cards at the end. So I hope you enjoyed that little fast forward through me doing all of the tags. We'll just have a little flip through. Just little abstract tags that we can write on the back of. I think this one's one of my favourites. I shouldn't say that, but sometimes you do have favourites. That one too. It's all exploration, fun and play. That's the last one. Okay. Got this one to glue on the front. It's kind of cute. Got a bit of the glue book there on there. That's it, gone. Let's put a little bit of our these on. Get rid of that page. It's getting a bit grungy. Now, I still didn't quite work out what to call this book, so I haven't stamped any letters there. Just needs to be perhaps a little abstract tag book. LTB. Should we just call it LTB? LATB. Right. Let's see. Little abstract tag book. That's a bit awkward, isn't it? I don't like it. Okay. Right. I was just going to say we might find a heading that we can put on. Eyewitness is a funny word to put on. But let's use it because, okay, that's perfectly okay to use a word that might seem a bit random. But eyewitness is a good word because when you think about it, our journals are our little witness, eyewitness. So it's writing down our eyewitnessing in life. There you are. I made it work. I just wanted to keep that number there, but I don't know that it's working. Still want the number. There we go. Now, I feel it still needs a little bit of colour. No. A little bit of that. I'll tell you what, I just thought maybe a date, stamp. I'll just get my stamper, my little vintage photo. I've got my little, this one's got all alphabets and numbers, so you can make dates or words. So I've just put tag March. Load up a bit more ink. It's not going to be super. Oh well, that's wibbly wobbly, and that is okay. It's not the best little stamper, but you can see what it is. March. It's my little tag book in March. So here we go. That's cute. Working through my finishing off things. As I said, I've been doing buttons. I've finished off a lot of buttons. I ended up doing some larger holes, so I've got quite a few that can be going on things. Not that one, that doesn't work. And what's next on my little list of things? All right, so this is a little book to finish, and this has got all sorts of things already on, but it just needs to be bound. I can do that, that's quite easy. I've got my needle holder, found a quite large eye to get this bit of string through. Just going to do a simple two-hole pamphlet stitch. That'll keep it together. These are little projects. A lot of these are just from workshops and from sometimes just watching people on YouTube and just going, oh, that's triggered me to think I wouldn't mind trying something like that. This was one of them. I think I was watching Mix It Up Marcy making her little cute little pear book, and just using all the different types of paper and stuff. She was drawing, doing a pair a day on each different sheet. Snip this a bit, don't want it that long. But I was really enjoying using this baking paper. So it's like parchment. It doesn't take the wet ink very well, but I was able to still get a bit of a wash over it. And then the gold pen worked really well. All right, let's have a look. So I was concentrating a little bit on green and gold. So I've got yellows, I've got the backgrounds, a watered down gold wash. Got a little, it's the same book. That's funny, well, they go together. Just little doodle books, ideas. Doodle books are good for just getting ideas if you really like something. I went on and explored this in my red work with the red stitching, the shell sort of motif. Room for more things. I mean, this is somewhere you could write. You can write journal entries into this. Bit more of the yellow. It's not full until it's really full. That's the way I think. There's definitely, I'd love to see penciled writing across this page. Free flow writing, that stream of consciousness writing almost. Okay, so I got really off track, so I've come back in with an overdub. What I started to talk about was kind of, it was just detracting from what this little book's about. And so I'm just going to show you the rest of these little pages and the flip throughs, seeing little bits that need re-gluing that have come off a bit, putting them down.
Whoever cares? All right, so there's one more little thing. So even though that I was considering these were things I was finishing off, clearly they're the start of new things. So there's only one more thing that I've got that I need to make something out of, and I won't do it in this video, but I made a whole heap of little cards on being a perfectionist, what it means. So they're little collages, individual ones. Perfectionism. I pulled out that the word perfectionism, perfecter, perfectionist, perfection, perfect, perfectibility. So they're little cards I've made. Now I might put those on my Etsy or something and put little frames on them. But what I'll do is photocopy them or scan them first so I've got some to play with. So that's something. Just thinking, I really like them, but I don't want to, I don't know. I don't want to just stick them in a book like this. I think they'd be nice for different people. So I think they are individual works. But they're collages, so they're proper artwork, proper collages. All right, I like them. I'm going to sell them. That's what I'm going to do. All right, I think I finally have finished my little bits and pieces that I had to catch up on. And thank you for watching. And I really do enjoy your company and for being here. And I will see you in the next one. Bye for now.